day from Betty Rocker. I hope you have a wonderful day, and remember to celebrate with people who love you.
Yeah, we broke up. No, I'm gonna celebrate it anyway. I'm gonna have a wonderful dinner with my two really good friends, and I'm going to make those heart-shaped ice cream sandwich cookies.
All right, let's bake cookies. We're gonna start out by mixing all of our dry ingredients together. And hey, don't worry if you don't have all the fancy bowls and mixing apparatuses. Baking should be fun. It does help me a lot to have all of my ingredients out before I start, so I know I have everything the recipe calls for, and pulling it together is kind of like quick and easy. I do like to cream the butter and sugar and mix the eggs on the side. I'll add my last two ingredients, the vanilla and the almond milk, into the eggs and beat them together. I do usually like to mix everything by hand, but an electric mixer does come in handy sometimes. This batter does make a very sticky dough, which is fine. This is kind of a unique cookie recipe in that when finished, the cookies are going to be served frozen, so they'll actually still need to be chewy and not hard at that temperature. I'm going to make the dough into two even-sized balls and put them into a freezer bag to chill in the refrigerator for about an hour before I decide to work with them again. In the meantime, I've got my pastry surface ready and I'll flour it so I can roll the cold dough out to about an eighth of an inch thick. It is important not to overwork this dough. We do want the cookies to be tender. So I couldn't find a heart-shaped cookie cutter. So as an alternative, you can always use a piece of paper and a sharp knife to cut out your shapes. Do try and get as many hearts onto the dough's surface as you can, because the unused pieces of dough will need to be rolled out again, and we want to do that as few times as possible. Line a cookie sheet with parchment paper and slide the hearts off of the pastry surface with a spatula. They're going to chill for 30 more minutes in the fridge while you make some more heart shapes with the rest of the dough. Go ahead and preheat your oven to 350 degrees. And perforate the surfaces with a fork. Pop them in the oven for 12 to 15 minutes and clean up your kitchen while they're baking. When they come out, you should have about a half dozen matching tops and bottoms. While they're cooling, take out your Ben & Jerry's frozen yogurt so it has a little time to warm up. If you don't let it do this, trying to spread it on the cookies will be ugly, trust me. I really love using this Cherry Garcia frozen yogurt for Valentine's Day because the cherry and subtle chocolate in the frozen yogurt is a perfect complement to the light sweet chocolate taste of the cookies. It's really awesome. As you can see, it's pretty easy to work with. All right, I've got my heart assembled and it looks like it came out pretty well. All right, I'm gonna pop these guys in the freezer to keep cold until I'm ready to serve them tonight.
These potatoes will absorb. All right, you might wanna catch that little part of the meat on the bottom of the spoon.
Yeah.
Just in case.
Oh my God, those are really good.
Oh,
they taste
my
like
God.
The worst Valentine's Day, not worst, but definitely not a great one to one of the best.
We have filet mignon, we have wild-caught Alaskan king salmon, which is actually reeled in by a fisherman on his private boat, a red berouge, and a heart-shaped crab cake.
Micah, you rock.
Thank you.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thank you for making us dinner.
Oh, no problem. It's my pleasure. It's awesome. Yeah.
I'm full.
Who put the rhyme in the ram-a-lam-a ding dong? Who put the bop in the bop shabop shabop? Who put the dip in the dip dip dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made